Good morning, children. Welcome to the English class. Unit 2, Poem, The Listeners. Written by Walter de la Mare. He was an English poet, short story writer, and novelist. He is best known for his works for children. The Listeners is said to be his most famous poem. Children, this is your memory poem. Let me read the poem. Listen carefully. The Listeners. Is there anybody there? Said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door. And his horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest ferny floor. And a bird flew up out of the turret above the traveler's head, and he smote upon the door again a second time. Is there anybody there? He said. But no one descended to the traveler, no head from the leaf-fringed sill leaned over and looked into his grey eyes, where he stood perplexed and still. But only a host of phantom listeners that dwelled in the lone house then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men. Stood thronging the faint moonbeams on the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall, hearkening in an air starred and shaken by the lonely traveler's call. Walter de la Mare. Before the explanation, I give the meaning for the outboards. Champed, bit and chewed upon noisily. Ferny, consisting of flowerless plants. Turret, a small tower that projects from the wall of a building. Smote, knocked loudly. Sill, a horizontal piece of timber beneath a window or a door. Perplexed, confused. Thronging, crowding. Hearkening, listening attentively. Dear children, once again I read out the poem stanza by stanza, then I give the explanation. Is there anybody there? Said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door. And his horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest ferny floor. And a bird flew up out of the turret above the traveler's head. Is there anybody there? Said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door. It was night time. A lonely traveler came to a lonely house in the forest. The moon was bright in the sky. The door looked bright in the moonlight. So the traveler knocked on the door, but there was no reply. And his horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest ferny floor. Champed means mellidal, bit and chewed upon noisily. Ferny means consisting of flowerless plants. There was complete silence everywhere. The horse was champing the grass noisily. அங்கே ரொம்ப அமைதியாக இருக்கிறதால ஹார்ஸ் கிராஸை மெல்றது ரொம்ப சத்தமாக கேட்குது. அண்ட் எ பேர்ட் ஃப்ளூ அப் அவுட் ஆஃப் த டரட் அபவ் த ட்ராவலர்ஸ் ஹெட். டரட் மீன்ஸ் எ ஸ்மால் டவர் தட் ப்ரொஜெக்ட் ஃப்ரம் த வால் ஆஃப் எ பில்டிங் ஆர் எ ஹவுஸ். A bird flew out from the top of the house. And he smote upon the door again a second time. Is there anybody there? He said. But no one descended to the traveler. No head from the leaf-fringed sill leaned over and looked into his grey eyes. Where he stood perplexed and still. And he smote upon the door again a second time. Is there anybody there? He said. But no one descended to the traveler. Smote means knocked loudly. There was no response. So the traveler knocked on the door a second time. He wanted to know if there was anyone inside. But no one descended to the traveler. Descended means came down. No one came down the stairs to meet the traveler. No head from the leaf-fringed sill leaned over and looked into his grey eyes. Fringed means decorated. Sill means a horizontal pieces of timber beneath a window or a door. தமிழில் திட்டுன்னு சொல்லுவோம். விண்டோஸ்க்கு பக்கத்தில் திட்டு மாதிரி இருக்கும், அதை தான் சில்லுன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. த விண்டோ சில் வாஸ் பார்டர்டு வித் எ லீவ்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிளைம்பர்ஸ். அந்த விண்டோ சில் எதால் கவர் ஆயிருக்குன்னா இலைகளால் கவர் ஆயிருக்கு. எப்படி கவர் ஆயிருக்குன்னா பார்டர் மாதிரி, அழகாக ஒரு பார்டர் மாதிரி கவர் ஆயிருக்கு. பட் நோ ஒன் புட் இஸ் ஹெட் அவுட் ஆஃப் தட் விண்டோ டு லுக் அட் த ட்ராவலர். No one projected out that window and looked at his grey eyes. Here, grey eyes mean by the traveler only, because the traveler had grey eyes. Where he stood perplexed and still, there was total silence. So the traveler was confused. Perplexed means confused. By standing near the door. But only a host of phantom listeners that dwelt in the lone house then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men. In the lonely house there were no people. Only the phantom in the house listened to him. Phantom means ghost. Only the ghost in the house listened to him. Why the traveler thought like that? For example, நம்ம ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ் வீட்டுக்கு போகிறோம். போன உடனே என்ன பண்ணுவோம்? காலிங் பெல் அடிப்போம். உள்ளே யாராவது இருந்தாங்கன்னா தான் வந்து டோர் ஓப்பன் பண்ணி நம்மளை வெல்கம் பண்ணுவாங்க. அங்கே யாருமே இல்லை அப்படின்னா நம்மளுக்கு எந்த ரெஸ்பான்ஸுமே இருக்காது. ஹியர் ஆல்சோ The traveler knocked on the door many times, but there is no response. So only the traveler thought in the lonely house there were no people. Only the ghost in the house listened to him. Then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men. The moonlight fell on the door brightly. The ghost from unreal world listened to the voice of men from the real world. The ghost lived in the house and they listened to the knock on the door. If the people are inside the house, sure they respond me. There were no people, only the ghost in the house. Stood thronging the faint moonbeams on the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall. Hearkening in an air, stirred and shaken by the lonely traveler's call. Thronging means crowding, hearkening means listening attentively. The rays of the moonlight fell dim and dull on the door. The dark stairs went down and reached the hall, which was empty. Only the air around was disturbed by the knock of the traveler. No one heard the call. Only the ghost inside the lonely house heard the call of the traveler. Thus, a sense of mystery surrounds the place.